Hello, everyone, and welcome to another Bass Singer Vocal Analysis. Now, I have never seen this video, so this technically is a first-time viewing, but I have heard the audio. It's one of my favorite songs by Home Free, one of their most popular. 17 million views on this song. So, now that we're back to our regularly scheduled content, we finished the Bass Gang up a few weeks ago. Huge success there. Thank you all for the support on that, and for humoring me and letting me do analyses to videos made by my own group. It was a lot of fun, as you could tell how passionate I was about them. But now we're back to groups like Pentatonix, Home Free, Jeff, Voiceplay, Dimash, all these wonderful artists that I haven't had a chance to explore during the months of May and partially the way through June. So now, I don't even remember the last time I did a Home Free song. I feel like it was like Mary Did You Know around Christmas time. So it's been a long time. I owe Home Free some love. I owe Tim Faust some brotherly bass love. And how better to do it than Man of Constant Sorrow? So guys, thanks for clicking on this video and checking it out. If you like my stuff, always throw a like on the video. Comment something below, doesn't matter what. Subscribe to the channel. And if you are gaining value, if you are gaining enjoyment in your musical experience from watching my content, if you're learning and it is just enhancing your musical experience in a kind of all-around way, please consider donating to my Patreon. Keeps the lights on. It helps support me as a young professional opera singer. The money in this career comes a bit later on, and it's greatly appreciated. And my Patreon family, we get closer by the day, and that is the place to interact with me. The YouTube following, the Instagram following, the numbers are going up and it's getting tougher and tougher to respond to everybody, which is just kind of the nature of how that goes, as much as I try. But Patreon, I will be engaged, and I'm active in the Discord server daily. You can ask anyone who's in my Patreon family. So that's that, guys. But let's dive in. Let's break down what's going on vocally in Home Free's Man of Constant Sorrow. It's been a while since I've revisited this song and I've never seen the video. Now, my commentary will not be as much video focused. You guys know this. It's going to be a lot of analysis. There's going to be pausing. If you want to watch this video straight through, I am probably the worst reactor to listen to because I pause and I talk about the voice a lot. Anyway, guys, here we go. Let's do it. Yep. Woo! A lot going on. The other fun thing about revisiting songs that I know but haven't really paid attention to is I hear much more. When I throw on these studio headphones and I'm listening critically, I hear much more. So we're going to get as much in over the course of about half an hour as we can. Let's start off right at the beginning. What's going on with these narrow, 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 narrow? So my guess is these are tenor voices that are pushing down into their bass range because they are singing. I think they're singing F2s. Yeah, so to me it sounds like a very forced push into the bass register. There's even some kind of overtones happening. There's like some of that kind of mixed in there. Or almost, it's almost like hinting at it, like the tongue position is like, that is the tongue position that would create overtones if they were going for that. But instead they're doing this kind of like froggy, almost like, it's almost vocal fry-y in the voice of whoever's doing these. And it's two of them. There's two different ones happening in the left and right ear, slightly different patterns. Anyway, we're 6 seconds in, guys. We're crushing it. It's only going to take 6 hours to get through this whole thing. Dumple, dumple, do. Dumple, dumple, do. Dump, dumple, do. So we got E flat 3, F3 in that baritone line. And then we got Jeff going, or Tim going, in his very, like he's a... Now, Tim can get a ton of resonance and cut in his bass sound. That's one great quality about his bass voice. But here it's clearly adopting a more breathy tone to start this song off. Nice riff they're starting in. For me, head voice, surely for Austin, that is upper check. Right, the flat 7, we're in F major. Nice. Easy for him. E flats are easy. And then that. Whatever sound effect Rupp is doing. Yeah. No, wait, we call Adam Chance, and we call Adam Rupp Adam. Right, Home Free Mega fans? Is that right? Anyway, cool sound effect from Beatbox Champ, Adam Rupp. Awesome. No, Chris Rupp. Adam. Chris Rupp was a previous member of Home Free, right? Guys, it's been so long since I've listened to Home Free that I'm getting spotty on the names. Wake up call.
I am a man in a constant sorrow. I've seen trouble all my days.
And a wonderful harmonica here there from Adam. Okay. So there's a lot of oohs happening in the upper voices. Tim in that first verse was on an mm. And then we have Austin, of course, taking over this solo and really sticking to the script of the original thus far. It is very much the original done a cappella. There's nothing super innovative, or they haven't added any original sections of their own. It's very by the book so far, but it's the song choice itself is kind of enough. You know, if you take a song like this, you'd kind of never expect to hear a cappella. Then just doing a really well done kind of transcription arrangement can be enough. Sometimes you don't have to do the hyper creative stuff like Voiceplay does. I'm personally a fan of it because I love when artists take risks, but it's not something you have to do. And for this particular song, I think their approach really is the right way to go. I think it serves them very well. So right now they're really sticking to the script of the original, and let's keep going.
Farewell, Kentucky, the place where I was born and raised.
I love how he allows his vibrato to come through. Actually, let's talk about these solo voices just a bit. Their technique.
I am a man in a constant sorrow. I've seen trouble all my time.
Nice. He even put a little grit in there. So Austin, I believe, is background in musical theater, and you really hear that shine through. He gets a very pure sound. There's no extra breath coming through. And then you really hear when he gets up into his high chest, into that kind of belt range. But it's just a very pure, very efficient sound. Neutral to high laryngeal position, spread vowels. He's keeping it all very bright and very forward. But especially when he ascends into his high chest, keeps it fully connected, doesn't even go... You know, when I hear him sing high notes, often doesn't even go into a mix. I mean, he really stays connected to his chest voice, which makes for a powerful sound. And then we have Rob. Rob and Rob has a similar approach, really. Let's talk about Rob.
Well, Kentucky, the place where I was born.
It's a little more wild. Place where I... You know, it's a little... less refined. It's almost like raw, like Austin's got, it sounds like more training, like musical theater training, maybe some formal training. Rob to me sounds like just like a super talented singer that just kind of like walked off the street and could like riff and had great vocal control. Now I really don't know that about his background, but just in the way that he delivers this first solo versus how Austin does. It seems like he's more of kind of like a wild, like a raw talent.
Kentucky, the place where I was born and raised.
The place where he was born and raised.
For 6 long years I've been in trouble. No pleasures here on earth I've found.
All right, keeping it the same here. Nothing added except for a little bit of perk, which has a lot of reverb. It's like, it's like a lot, it's giving like this kind of atmosphere to it. But aside from that, we still have ooze in the background. I think, what's is Tim either on an mm or an ooh?
No pleasures here on earth I've found.
Yeah, he's on mm, right? He's on mm for the first, these first two verses. You see what I mean with the kind of wild, raw talent? I'm hearing it again here, right off that first ascension. C to F four, so up to high F. This is kind of going into the second passaggio of the tenor voice, which you really, you deal with that much more in the operatic world as a classical vocalist. The passaggio doesn't cause nearly as much trouble for non-opera singers, for a number of reasons I'm not going to get into right now. But F4 is kind of right in the middle there, and it's very smooth. But it but his voice, his approach to it, just feels a little more like let's just go for it, as opposed to Austin's, which feels a little more planned. Kind of like slides into it.
Bound to ramble, I have no friends to help me now.
He has no friends to help him now.
There we go.
It's fare thee well, my old true lover. I never expect to see you again.
Yeah, so this is easy singing. This is like Robin Austin could sing this for 8 hours in a day and their voices would be fine. It's just right in that kind of mid, like just above their middle, but not dealing with anything tricky, not having to push, not even having to strategize about their singing, really. It's just like, here's my voice, boop, boop, there you go. It's just what it is. And you can tell how easy it sounds. Now, you don't go off how it looks in music videos because they're all lip-synced. Fact. But you don't want to go off what you see necessarily, although usually singers try to somewhat mimic how they look. But like, for example, you might have a bass that has an extremely low note and they might sing it like this, like chin tucked in, like triple chin, trying to get down there. And in the video, they're like doing like a sexy look at the camera. Yeah, that's what you can do in a music video. So you got to go by the ear. And what you get when you listen to Austin singing by ear is that it's very easy and natural for him.
I never expect to see you again.
Easy money.
Oh,
great harmonica.
I'm bound to ride that northern railroad. Perhaps I'll die upon this train.
Perhaps he'll die.
Awesome. So again, sticking very much to the original, but it's so good. It's just so well done. The drums are so, the singing's great and the engineering for groups like Home Free, groups like Voice Play, it's just unbelievable how crisp they get the voices sounding in these studio productions. The closest, when we used to record a bunch of my undergrad, we worked with one of the best a cappella producers in the country and the sound was crisp, but we didn't have nearly the talent of like these groups, so it obviously didn't sound as good. The closest recently is if you watch the Bass Gang's cover of Iris, that was mixed by a professional a cappella mixer, Johnny Stewart, and you can hear it's just a little more crisp, especially the vocal percussion. That's where the big change is between like semi-pro or amateur mixing and professional is the vocal percussion. I mean, it's crazy. And I know, of course, these beatboxers are incredible, but just trust me, from experience as a beatboxer and producer and acapella and all that stuff, it's amazing how good they make this vocal percussion sound, because it's VP is really tough to record. It just is. You know, mics are good at picking up voices. They're not great at picking up vocal percussion very well. So it's just so crisp and it just sounds fantastic. There we go. Even Tim, now he's getting pretty good vocal closure. He's allowing a little, just ever so slight amount of breath to come through. But it's his bass voice is very present. Like, it has much more high overtones when he wants it to than Avi, for example. Avi's like all like, just like warm chocolatey bass. Whereas Tim generally has more cut, more bite to the sound. And you can kind of feel the sound like buzzing in the front of his face when he's doing this bass. And I think it's great. And you've got to have that. If you're singing unmiked with bass voice, you have to have cut or you just won't be heard. You can be heard in a studio setting because you can change the levels and they have the engineering. But Tim's voice, like if he were to sing in a chamber choir, I bet he would sound excellent because his voice has so much nice buzz down there. Me, it's not like me, you can bury me, you can bury me. It's got a lot of nice presence down there.
In Sunny Valley, for many years where I may lay.
So that verse is one of my favorite bass solos. I just love it. It's so simple, but it sounds so good in Tim's voice. I think I sang it on like a TikTok like a year or two ago just for fun. It's a favorite of mine. But then at this we get this ending part where he... What? Is that what he does? Let's find out. He has this ascending bass line from something crazy low.
While I am sleeping in my grave,
while he is sleeping,
ba-na-na-na. A, B flat, B, C, except down here.
While I am sleep, while he is sleep.
Crazy. That's probably full chest. Tim does have a very good blend into his chest fry, and a very strong chest fry. We are kindred spirits, and that chest fry is our go-to extended technique. Love you, Tim. Let's do it together sometime, dude. I mean, come on. So let's see. I think this is probably full chest, because I'm pretty sure basically 24/7, if you just listen to his speaking voice, I bet Tim has an A1 chest all day.
Deep in my grave.
Yeah, that's chest. What is he singing?
Maybe your friend.
Maybe you. Maybe. Oh, are we in F minor instead? I said F major earlier. Do, do. We are in F minor. Maybe your friends up to a high flat with a nice riff back down.
Friends stay.
Okay, so he goes C up to a high A flat, back down to a lower A flat in that little passage there.
Think I'm just maybe your friend's thing. I'm just a stranger.
I like that. That's not in the original.
My face you never see no more. I'll meet you on God's golden shore.
He'll meet you on God's golden shore.
Here we go.
So you notice that verse, they stripped it back again. So that was their way in this song of creating some change here. So we have pretty much transcription, following the books throughout there. And then to switch things up, they pulled the drums back. They had less activity in the background voices, and it was much more of a focus. Did they even have bass?
That is given.
They did have bass, just on ooze. And it was mostly just the focus on Austin's solo here, but it allowed for contrast between the verses we'd heard and this verse, and then, of course, the final verse. They'll bring all the instruments back. So it's a nice touch. Anyone arranging out there, if you're going to do a transcription-like arrangement, this is a great way to create contrast and create interest throughout your song.
I'll meet you on God's golden shore.
He'll meet you on God's golden shore.
Here we go.
A little scratch from Rob. Oh no, that was the last verse. Okay, so they just... Oh, that's funny. What up, Gator? That's interesting. So it was actually Chance who was doing now, what he was kind of like I'm doing now, because Chance has a lower chest range than I do. Clearly, like, forcing his voice to be smaller and kind of compressed. He's not going, he's going, now. You can almost hear the overtones in there, like I mentioned earlier. Interesting, though. Okay, so that's how they finished the song. So Tim was really their big shift away from the original. Give it to the bass voice, set it down an octave, throw an A1 chest in there, and you've got yourself some contrast. And then they stripped it back. So this final verse was actually more just stripped back. They removed, that's so interesting. Usually what you get is you'll get the stripped back verse, and then the group will come back in with much more fire and, you know, however they want to finish the song, but usually with a lot more zeal. And interesting, cool. And for some reason I had just forgotten that. Like I said, you know, when you're just listening for pleasure, you're not really paying attention. It's kind of just like binary. Do I like listening to this? Or do I not? And then you get into doing these analyses as someone like me with such a long and extensive background in music, and you start really listening with nice studio headphones, and then you go from binary 0-1 to like 100 different gradations on like 100 different scales. We're talking arrangement. We're talking technique. We're talking the bass. We're talking the perk. We're talking the blend. We're talking the balance, man. Just a ton of things to talk about. Even in a song like this that, I mean, for the most part, bar for bar, is a lot like the original, just done a cappella. I think the original's longer. I want to say the original's longer. I feel like they might have dropped a verse or two, which, fair enough. I mean, it is very repetitive, the original, and I love it. Soggy Bottom Boys. I think I first heard it in Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Great movie, classic movie. Go watch it if you haven't. Anyway, guys, we're back in the fold. I think this is going to be video number 3 post-Bass Gang. Yeah, I'm glad to be back doing it. I mean, I had so much fun, so much passionate listening and viewing to the Bass Gang stuff. But I love analyzing groups like this. Home Free, one of my favorites. You will have recently heard Voice Plays Enemy, biggest, maybe the most request I've ever gotten for a song, Dimash's new song. So now we're back on track, guys. I've got some new content coming out soon, which I'll have news for. Some very exciting projects. But anyway, guys, like the video, comment on the video, subscribe to the channel, and go join my Patreon family for early access to all releases, behind the scenes access for tiers 2 up on all projects. That's like rough cuts, early drafts, demos, behind the scenes pictures, behind the scenes footage from video shoots and stuff like that. And then cooler and cooler tiers as you go up, man. And there's some really good stuff on there. If there wasn't, I would not have any top tier patrons, but I do. And I thank them, and I thank you guys for all the support. So that's it, guys. Home free, Man of Constant Sorrow. And yeah, feels good to be back. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.